So friends, once again I welcome you all here with a new video on some of the important questions on William Shakespeare, the great dramatist of all time and a great writer of English literature. So friends, this particular video is going to help those students who are preparing for NET SET as well as TGT and PGT exams, as well as some of the important exams based on English literature. So this particular topic I have added here, and some of the important questions I have collected for you. So let's begin the questions. So first question is, Shakespeare was born in 1564. It is the year in which Shakespeare was born, in Stratford-upon-Avon. Stratford-upon-Avon, it is a place name. So there he was born in 1564. Then during his lifetime, Shakespeare wrote 38 plays and 54 sonnets. Yes friends, 38 plays and 54 sonnets. Sometimes it is a little bit confusing, because some people opined that there are only 36 plays by Shakespeare. Some says that there are only 37 plays, but it is little bit complicated. So I have read it well from one authentic book, and I have outlined here this 38 plays and 154 sonnets by Shakespeare. Then, to which theater Shakespeare was generally associated? So it was Globe Theater, friends. To Globe Theater he was generally associated. Name of the first play written by Shakespeare. It was Henry VI. Henry VI was the first play written by Shakespeare. Then the character, if Touchstone appears in Shakespeare's which play? The character of Touchstone, not if, there is a spelling mistake, friends. So the character of Touchstone appears in As You Like It, a romantic comedy by Shakespeare. In this particular play, Touchstone's character appears. Then which play of Shakespeare has the character of Lady Capulet? Lady Capulet is a character name, and it appears in Romeo and Juliet. Then the literary period of Shakespeare is considered between, so here we have to identify the literary period, and that literary period is 1564 to 1616. So Elizabethan age and the Jacobean age, in between this literary period is considered as the period of Shakespeare. Then Shakespeare's famous tragedies were published in Jacobean age. Most of the tragedies are published in Jacobean age, not in Elizabethan age. Then the sonnets written by Shakespeare were addressed to the first 126 to a man, any unknown man, and the last 127 to 154 to a dark lady. In fact, 127 to 152 to a dark lady. These sonnets were addressed. And other two were addressed to someone else, and it was Cupid, the god of love. Then non-dramatic poetry of Shakespeare includes Venus and Adonis and Lucrece. Two poetry were written by Shakespeare, non-dramatic poetry, and these were Venus and Adonis and Lucrece, two different poems. Then the period of the great comedies and chronicles play by Shakespeare is 1594 to 1600. Great comedy, comedies and chronicle plays period. So this period was between 1594 to 1600, in which chronicle plays were written by Shakespeare and comedies were written by Shakespeare. Then the period of the great tragedies were by Shakespeare is 1601 to 1608. So in during this timeline, the tragedies by Shakespeare were written and published. Then which writer influenced Shakespeare's Love's Labour's Lost? It was John Lyly. Yes, friends. John Lyly was the person who influenced Shakespeare's work, Love's Labour's Lost. Then, which play of Shakespeare is considered as artistic failure by T.S. Eliot? So it was Hamlet. Yes, T.S. Eliot considered Hamlet as an artistic failure by Shakespeare. Then, brevity is the soul of wit is a quotation given by William Shakespeare. Brevity is a soul of wit. It is a great quotation given by William Shakespeare. Then, who stated that Shakespeare is he in his comedies has only heroines and no heroes? So this particular statement was given by John Ruskin. John Ruskin once stated that Shakespeare in his comedies has only heroines and no heroes. Then Sir John Falstaff is one of Shakespeare's greatest comic figures. So comic figure it he is. Sir John Falstaff, the character of John Falstaff is a comic figure in Shakespeare's plays. Then Shakespeare made fun of the Puritans in his play Twelfth Night. Twelfth Night is a play by Shakespeare in which he just made fun of the Puritans. Then, which character of Shakespeare's play exclaimed, "Brave New World"? That particular phrase, "Brave New World," was exclaimed by Miranda in The Tempest. The Tempest is a play by Shakespeare in which the character Miranda exclaimed that, "Brave New World." Then, identify the earliest comedy of Shakespeare. And it is Love's Labour's Lost, which was also influenced by that particular writer, John Lyly. Yes. Then, I have no other but a woman's reason. I think him so because I think him so. Which of Shakespeare's play contain above lines? So, there is one play of Shakespeare which has the above lines. I have no other but a woman's reason. I think him so because I think him so. So it was in The Two Gentlemen of Verona. The Two Gentlemen of Verona has the above line. Then most of the plays of Shakespeare were written as quarto texts. Quarto texts means a sheet of paper folded four ways. A separate paper, a sheet of paper folded four ways. It is quarto text, and most of his plays are written in such texts. Then Shakespeare's As You Like It, is based on Thomas Lodge's Rosaline. Thomas Lodge's Rosaline is a great work by Thomas Lodge, and on which the play As You Like It is based on. And there is also one character named Rosaline in Shakespeare's As You Like It. Then name the poet on whose poem Romeo and Juliet is based. So it was Arthur Brooke. Yes, friends, Arthur Brooke was the poet on whose poem Romeo and Juliet is based. And the poem by Brooke is the tragical history of Romeo's and Juliet. The tragical history of Romeo's and Juliet. It is a verse poem by Arthur Brooke on which the poem of Shakespeare, Romeo and Juliet, is based. Then, the play All's Well That Ends Well is based on William Painter's Palace of Pleasure. Yes, friends, All's Well That Ends Well is a play by Shakespeare, and it was based on William Painter's Palace of Pleasure. It is a work by William Painter, and it is the base for the All's Well That Ends Well. Then Boccaccio's Decameron was used as a source in which play of Shakespeare? So it was Cymbeline. Cymbeline was the play by Shakespeare, probably his last play. So in this particular play, this the Decameron, Boccaccio's Decameron was used as a source. Then identify the person who first used the term problem play for some of the plays of Shakespeare. So it was Frederick S. Boas. Frederick S. Boas just identified some of the plays by Shakespeare as problem play. And it was first used by Frederick S. Boas for Shakespeare's plays. Which plays of Shakespeare were problem plays according to Frederick S. Boas? So, All's Well That Ends Well, Measure for Measure, and Troilus and Cressida. These are the three plays by Shakespeare which are considered as problem plays by Boas. Then, the story of Venus and Adonis is taken from Ovid's Metamorphoses. Ovid's Metamorphoses is the source for the story of Venus and Adonis by Shakespeare. Then the poem Phoenix and Turtle is an allegorical poem. Phoenix and Turtle is a poem by Shakespeare published in 1601, and it is an allegorical poem by Shakespeare. Then Shakespeare composed much of his plays in what sort of verse? So it was in iambic pentameter, blank verse we can say. Okay, so in iambic pentameter, he composed most of his plays. Then which roles were played by Shakespeare in Hamlet and in As You Like It? So there are two plays in which Shakespeare played a role as an actor. So in the play Hamlet, he played the role of ghost, and in As You Like It, he played the role of an old servant, Adam. Then brevity is the soul of wit. It's stated by Shakespeare in his Hamlet, in his play Hamlet. This question, I think it is repeated, but for more information, you can say that here this particular statement is used by Shakespeare in his play Hamlet. So Hamlet is a play in which this particular statement we can read. Then, Tales from Shakespeare is written by Charles Lamb and Mary Lamb. Charles Lamb and Mary Lamb. These are two brother and sisters, and these two writers have written this particular work, Tales from Shakespeare, which is also considered as children's literature. Then, Shakespeare is also known as England's national poet and the Bard of Avon. England's national poet and Bard of Avon he is known as. Then the work which published after Shakespeare's death and which classified his works into comedies, histories, and tragedies is First Folio. Yes, friends, First Folio is the title of that work, which was published in 1623 with a name that Mr. Shakespeare's Comedies, Histories, and Tragedies. And it was published posthumously after Shakespeare's death. Who prepared this First Folio? So Shakespeare's contemporary, his friends, John Hemmings and Henry Condell, two friends were there who prepared this First Folio. The First Folio includes a preface with a poem by Ben Jonson. Ben Jonson narrated his own poem in the preface to the First Folio. Then, who acclaimed Shakespeare as not of an age but for all time? So it was Ben Jonson himself who acclaimed Shakespeare as not of an age but for all time. Then identify the sonnet style of Shakespeare. So it is AB, CD, CD, EF, EF, and GG. So very important sonnet style it is, and it is also considered as English sonnet style, and it is very different from Petrarchan sonnet style. Then, who called Shakespeare as an upstart crow? So it was Robert Greene, who stated that Shakespeare is an upstart crow in Grotesque of Wit. It is a pamphlet by Robert Greene in which he stated Shakespeare as an upstart crow. Then this sonnet titled as On Shakespeare is written by John Milton. John Milton wrote a sonnet named On Shakespeare, and it was published in 1630 by John Milton. Then identify the character who appears in three different plays of Shakespeare: Merchant of Venice, Comedy of Errors, and Much Ado About Nothing. So it was Balthasar. Balthasar was the person, the character who appears in three different plays of Shakespeare. Then identify the character who appears in two plays of Shakespeare: Midsummer Night's Dream and Titus Andronicus. So it was Demetrius. Demetrius, the character of Demetrius appears in two different plays of Shakespeare: Midsummer Night's Dream and Titus Andronicus. Then the famous quote, "All the world is a stage," appears in the play As You Like It. All the world's a stage is a statement, famous statement by Shakespeare, and it appears in his play As You Like It. The Moor of the Venice is the subtitle of the play Othello. So Othello has a subtitle named as The Moor of the Venice. The term motiveless malignity is applied to the character of Iago by S.T. Coleridge. So Coleridge applied this term motiveless malignity to the character of Iago, and this particular character Iago appears in Othello. Then which play is believed as written by Shakespeare in collaboration with Thomas Middleton? Thomas Middleton is a person with whom Shakespeare collaborated for a work, and it is believed that it was written like that. What is the truth? No one knows, but it is believed that it is a collaborative work, and this work is Timon of Athens. Timon of Athens is a work which was written by Shakespeare in collaboration with Thomas Middleton. Then the first 17 sonnets written by Shakespeare are known as procreation sonnets. Procreation sonnets is a term used for first 17 sonnets written by Shakespeare. Procreation sonnets. Then sonnets from 18 to 126 are called as fair youth sonnets. Fair youth sonnets is a term used for sonnets from 18 to 126 number. Then the sonnets 153 and 154 are dedicated to Cupid, god of love. So last two sonnets of his life, 53rd number, 54th number, are dedicated to Cupid, god of love. So friends, that's all from Shakespeare, and some of the very important questions I have collected here for you. And I don't think that apart from these questions, any question from Shakespeare can be asked, okay? Because important questions I have collected here. So that's all for today. You can follow me on these social media platforms, and also subscribe my channel for further videos and updates on English literature related exams. So that's all, and thank you so much, friends.